Hello, everyone. Welcome to Shady Entertaining. Why am I speaking thusly? Well, because today I'm going to do another snarky response to a few comments posted by some Last Jedi apologists. These comments weren't made all directly to me. They were comments that I've heard on other people's channels, and they were comments that were said to other people who heard it from a friend who heard it from a friend who thought the Last Jedi was just peachy keen. I don't know what that is. Is that that's Ario Speedwagon? Or is that Journey? Tell me in the comments, who was that? It's either Chicago or Journey, Ario Speedwagon, or the Bee Gees. I'm sure it's one of those, so just let me know in the comments, you guys, because I'm having a brain fart right now. This has become a meme that too. Love this happy taste.
Heard it from a friend who heard it from a friend who heard it from another. You've been messing around.
Well, yes. So this is what I'm talking about. A commenter by the name of Raycon Zion, who actually, first of all, I'm going to say this. Now, this Raycon Zion, I hope I'm saying your name right, he is not the guy I'm riling against. No, he's the guy who actually brought my attention to all these apologists. So he's not the guy, he's not the one that I'm talking about. He's the one who brought my attention to this. But before he did that, he actually had a really good point concerning my last video. As you recall, my last video was about how Rian Johnson managed to get his trilogy. Whether or not Rian Johnson will still get his trilogy, I am uncertain about. There are many, many people such as Stephanie Janiczek who think that there's no way in hell. Check out her channel, by the way, Stephanie Janiczek. She's really good. You want to talk about a strong female lead? Well, she's one of them. She's really good and she hates The Last Jedi. And when I mean hates The Last Jedi, hates The Last Jedi. She's no apologist, that's for sure. So check out her channel. I'll leave a link to her on the bottom. So she obviously thinks it's not going to go down. I wish I had her confidence, but I don't. I'm still think that this travesty might go down, but I'm hoping or beyond hope that it doesn't. Now, Raycon Zion said to me about my theory. He said, so I'm going to paraphrase him. I'm not going to say exactly what his words are, but his effect on why Rian Johnson managed to procure a trilogy from Kathleen Kennedy went more thusly. He's under the impression, I tend to actually believe him, because I actually think that his ideas has got merit, that Kathleen Kennedy is running the Lucasfilm like the queen. I am now the crowned queen of Lucasfilm, and I shall run the Star Wars with an iron fist. The queen shall rule with an iron fist, as I have become the dominatrix of directors. Lord Miller, yes, I did hire you, but you are nothing but fools. Do as I command or then perish. How dare you dort speak to your queen such disrespect. I shall rule up my feminist weekly pages if you've been bad boys, naughty boys. Bad, that's right, take the feminist weekly pages to the head. Bad boys, you've been bad naughty boys. How dare you contradict your queen? Why can't you be more like Rian Johnson? Oh, he's a good boy. Oh, Rian, please kneel before your queen, Rian.
Yes, so majesty, oh yes.
Oh, you're such a good boy. Want me to scratch you on your ears? Oh yes, you like your little scratchies, don't you?
Oh yes.
Oh yes, you've done well, haven't you? You've done everything Kathleen Kennedy wants. Yes, you have. All the women are dominant, and the men are on the floor like groveling fools. As according to my plan, and you've made it all possible, because you are a good pet, aren't you, Rian?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Because you're such a good boy, I shall give you a treatise. Rian, you want some treaties? Look what Mommy has for being such a good boy. She's got some treaties. You like your treaties?
Oh yes, I want trees. Can I have three? Can I have a trilogy of trees?
Oh, you may have, because you're such a good boy. Here you go, take the trilogy.
Oh God, thank you. Oh, love these treaties. I'm going to devour them.
Oh, you're such a good boy. Come, Rian, have some bitty.
Oh, goody, I get bitty.
Yes, have the bitty. Yes, suckle upon the teat. Suckle upon the teat, Rian. You know you like teat suckling. That's why you made Luke Skywalker do it.
Mummy, I love your pity.
This is the reward if you play nice with Kathleen Kennedy.
That's pretty much what he said. Not word for word, because his comments was a lot shorter than that. His comment actually went like this. This is an easy one to answer. He was speaking in reference to how did Rian Johnson get his trilogy. He got it basically doing Kathleen's bidding. Everything she wanted to the letter. Basically shitting on every male character in TLJ while underpowering every female in it. Or I think he meant overpowering every female in it. But that's what he put. And from that I got the bitchy. So I took a few liberties and I hope he doesn't mind. Thank you, Rakian. So that's not all I'm here to talk about, guys. Because like I said, this isn't the only one. And then he started talking about, he was conversing with an SJW, and an SJW who apparently is a Raylo, and right away, you know that she's from a galaxy way farther away. She's a Raylo fan. So, what she said was that she likes what happened to Luke Skywalker.
I love it. I love what happened to Luke Skywalker. And you know,
again, I'm paraphrasing.
Why? Because Luke Skywalker, he needed to know what failure was. You see, he was a young farm boy who became a Jedi, and he was thrust into greatness without ever failing. He never failed at all. Not Luke Skywalker. He didn't know what failure was. No, no, not him. Not him. Raylo, on the other hand, she knows exactly what failure is. Not Luke.
In case you hadn't noticed, that was some sarcasm, guys. Well, I'm getting ready for the comments, because I know I'm going to get some doozies. So she's saying that Luke Skywalker apparently, you know, needed to learn what failure was, because, you know, he didn't fail at anything. He didn't fail at his training the first time he tried it, right, guys? That was all successful? So he tried to lift the ship?
Judge me by your size, you do?
Goes into that thing where he raises the ship. You ask for the impossible.
That is why you fail.
He said it right out of his mouth. Let's hear that in instant replay.
That is why you fail.
One more time.
Fail you do at everything. Suck you do.
I'm paraphrasing for Yoda now. Right? So he failed in his training. So that's one failure. Then he rushes head on to go meet Vader. I've got to save them. I got to save my friends. So he rushes over to the Cloud City, meets Vader, and then succeeded in fighting Vader, right? That was another success for Luke. Look at all the success this guy's having. Oh, remember the bar scene? See, he's not a Mary Sue because he's not liked. My friend doesn't like you. Well, I'm sorry to hear that. I don't like you either. Nobody liked him. So he's not definitely not a Mary Sue. And not just that, he had to be rescued a whole bunch of times. I mean, when has Rey ever had to be rescued? I mean, you're talking about a guy who never failed. He almost froze to death, had to be in the ice on Hoth, and he had to be saved by Han Solo. And at the end of A New Hope, use the Force, Luke, and the thing went down. He didn't do that on his own, right? He would have failed, right? Vader would have blasted him had it not been for Han Solo's last-minute rescue by shooting the last remaining ships. So he would have failed then had it not been for his friends. So really, what has he done? What has Luke... The only thing he succeeded in was turning his father. The only thing. Everything Luke has ever done, he did with the help of his friends. Sure, he had some success. But to say that he never failed? Yeah, so that's just revisionist history to say that he never failed. Like, and meanwhile, she seems to like have no issue with Rey. Mrs. Mary Sue there was all perfect. And, you know, failed at absolutely nothing. Except for maybe to turn Kylo Ren at the end. That's the only thing she didn't succeed in. And we all know that's probably eventually going to happen. But she had the audacity to say that Luke needed to complete his story arc, right? He needed to complete his story arc by acknowledging that he had so many successes and that being this perfect Jedi for all these years, and you know, he had to come to grips with his own hubris, like the rest of the Jedi were, you know, sniffing his own farts and being, you know, thinking he was all that in a bag of chips. He had to come down to Earth and realize that the only way to grow is through failure. That's Luke, a guy who's well into his probably 60s, 70s by now if you see him. He apparently has never had any complications in his life and has no knowledge of failure. And in fact, this is how Luke Skywalker, according to her, is supposed to handle failure. You know, he doesn't handle failure like a hero. He handles failure like a pussy. And so because he can't save his nephew from the dark side, he handles it by brandishing a lightsaber in a menacing fashion over the bed of his nephew, right? Really? West Philadelphia, born and raised. On the playground was where he spent most of his days. Imagine Uncle Phil, you know, Will Smith comes over and he's like, I can't save this boy. And then you see Uncle Phil with a Glock over Will Smith's bed because he can't save him. He's too dark. Will wakes up. Uncle Phil! He's like, I'm sorry. I don't know what I was thinking. That would go over. Well, it's like there's a blockage in their brain. Like, there's a dead spot somewhere that they can't see how ridiculous and how asinine that is. It's like a nihilistic blind spot that this generation seems to have, where they think that that's okay. Brandishing a lightsaber, that's just a minor little issue. I mean, come on, man. Do you not see that's not typical for a hero to do? That's not a minor failure. That's attempted murder. That's not a minor little failure. He didn't fail at something. He just there's also a difference between trying something and failing and then just giving up. See, a hero doesn't give up when he fails, right? A hero's journey, if you try to continue it saying that he finally failed, then he doesn't lose hope when he fails. And apparently, this Luke Skywalker, when he does finally fail, loses all hope. Sits on an island like, Schmeeder, because Schmeeder's is, could not save us, his precious nephew's is. And so he sits on an island.
Here's my island is. I made a mapsis so that I don't be founses. That makes sense, Nazis?
Why are we even wasting breath in this kind of argument? I don't even know, but it gets in your brain and it bothers you and it festers in there. And you're like, and they excuse all of Rey. Rey is excused. She doesn't need a story arc, just Luke. Luke's story arc is all that matters. You know, that just boggles the mind.
Yeah!